Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting this video, there was a really interesting article posted in relation to Starlink. It says, engineering researchers have developed a method to use signals broadcast by Starlink Internet Service satellites to accurately locate a position here on Earth, much like GPS does. It is the first time the Starlink system has been harnessed by researchers outside SpaceX for navigation. There was another interesting bit of information with this tweet. It says, an interesting note from the Aerospace Safety Advisory Panel meeting. Panel member David West says SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft will do a 360-degree flyaround of the ISS after departing in early mid-November, the first 360-degree flyaround by a US crew craft since the shuttle. For the Boca Chica action, here's a view of the orbital launch site. An oxygen tank was seen venting as they did some testing of the orbital tank farm. Cryo shell number 5 was lifted over GSE tank 1. The chopstick catching arms for Mechazilla have been continuing construction. They recently lifted and installed the quick disconnect arm extension onto the launch tower QD arm. This thrust simulator was rolled out to the launch site for ship 20 proof testing. Then there was also an RVAC thrust simulator moved to the launch site. The foundations for the wider high bay have been continuing. The whole Blue Origin against NASA and SpaceX fiasco continues, and this tweet from Eric Berger was recently posted. He said, the full redacted complaint filed to the US Court of Federal Claims by Blue Origin against NASA in August was publicly released today. Then he responded to his tweet with, Blue Origin seeks the following. Ruling that NASA award to SpaceX was arbitrary, capricious, and an abuse of discretion. Work stoppage, allow for revisions to proposals and NASA to make a new selection. Payment for all Blue Origin attorney fees. Christian Davenport also posted a tweet on this where it was claimed that SpaceX will not do flight readiness reviews for HLS Starship launches. It says, here's the relevant section of the SpaceX white paper refuting the claim that they won't do flight readiness reviews of Starship HLS launches. It also points out that they have a track record of 130 successful orbital launches, including with crew and vital national security satellites. Musk responded with, we always do flight readiness reviews. This argument makes no sense. The ground support equipment tank GSE-8 was moved out of the midbay. Starship 20 continues to await testing on the suborbital pad B mount. Ship 21's upper bulkhead was recently sleeved with the ring stack. Booster 4 was lifted off the orbital mount, I believe for catching arm installation. Taking a look at the road and beach closures, no testing happened during the week as they continue to prepare the prototypes. Right now, there are closures for possible testing tomorrow, Monday 27th, Tuesday and Wednesday. Here's a view of the Super Heavy Booster 5 prototype in the high bay being put together. Finally, for today's video, we have the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. The prototypes that will follow in the footsteps of Booster 4 and Ship 20 when they launch are progressing nicely. As always, I have to thank Mary or Boca Chica Girl for being out in Boca Chica filming the content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.